Counterinsurgency is a specialized form of warfare waged by a state against its population. An insurgency is an organized revolt by people against an established authority. Most commonly throughout history, it's an anti-colonial, some kind of anti-imperialist resistance movement.
Counterinsurgency is the technical art of counter-revolution.
At its broadest, counterinsurgency refers to the whole range of activities that a state engages in to repress an uprising.
Counterinsurgency is basically the constant war that states carry out in order to manage conflict and ensure the stability and continuity of governance.
Counterinsurgency is designed to keep a movement which is at a formative stage, which is weak and vulnerable. They are designed to keep them at that stage and to be able to crush them, make them lose legitimacy, or keep them from getting any real legitimacy for their demands or their grievances.
Under the counterinsurgency philosophy, conflict is permanent. Therefore, state institutions need to always be the arbiters and the mediators of conflict. They therefore need the legitimacy to be seen as neutral arbiters, to be seen as the only ones with the resources or the capability to offer a solution to a problem.
There's always a thing within counterinsurgency that it's always supposed to be operating within the rule of law and within a democratic context. At least that's sort of the modern counterinsurgency is the ideal, that the soldiers won't be out on the street. It won't be evidently a war.
The objective is to maintain the level of conflict at the lowest levels, at levels of simple dissidence or nonviolence, and not allow those conflicts to evolve to more insurrectional or revolutionary levels.
As it has developed as a term of art in the military literature, it has come to refer to a specific approach, a specific philosophy as to how that is best done. And that approach is characterized less by reliance on sheer coercive force and more by the use of soft power, the shaping of social conditions, the co-optation of movement leaders into the state apparatus, and the offering of concessions and reforms to undercut popular support for the uprising.
Former British military officer Frank Kitson, in a book called Low Intensity Operations, talks about the need to find and neutralize subversive elements in the population and to remove the masses from the leadership of the subversive movement. And one of the key components of that is attaching parts of the resistance movement that engage in nonviolent civil disobedience type of campaigns, attaching those types of elements to the state as a means of dividing the resistance movement and undermining the more radical or militant components.
Big nonprofit groups are responsible for subverting radical political change, and they play a big role in the counterinsurgency. Their goal is to channel people in directions that will not put them in the position of directly confronting the state.
Basically, counterinsurgency as a state philosophy arose as specialists working for the state, as state institutions analyzed their failures and weaknesses in the anti-colonial struggles of the 50s and 60s. And the particularly urban and other domestic struggles within powerful colonizing states of the 60s and 70s.
Back in the 60s and 70s, you had more of a revolutionary consciousness among many people in the United States. A lot of it was influenced on the revolutions that were actually the armed revolutions that were going on in Africa and Southeast Asia at the time. They did not want these kinds of groups to ever exist again. They did not want groups like the Black Panther Party to ever be able to come into existence again.
Counterinsurgency, because it's a type of warfare, involves all the means of war, including political, economic, military, cultural, and ideological, as well as psychological measures.
A huge part of counterinsurgency is about hearts and minds. That's what they say. But really, it's not about actually offering people services or actually providing them with a better life. It's about saying that that's what you're doing and repressing people to the point that their silence becomes consent for whatever kind of rule you decide is appropriate in that moment as the sort of state or as the elite ruler. It's all about fear. It's about managing people through fear.
And when you see these thugs being thrown into the back of a paddy wagon, you just see them thrown in, rough. I said, please don't be too nice.